Hey everyone, welcome back to Nick Farrell Reacts, my channel where I react to music and content here. Lately it's been a whole lot of Taylor Swift. I've been enamored by her voice and her ability to write lyrics that are not only relatable, but have depth and vulnerability. And so we've been chugging along on Folklore, about halfway through, I believe, and I have very few critical things to talk about in terms of critiques. It's just been slight, frankly, kind of a masterpiece, but it also appeals to my love of folk. Today I'm doing something a little different. We're going to be looking at Tolerate It. A Patreon subscriber of mine requested this song, so that's why I am jumping to Evermore. I know that that's the fifth track on Evermore. And I know that it's supposed to be one of her more emotional songs. That's all I know about it. Never heard it. But I'm really looking forward to it, and I will eventually get to Evermore. If you haven't already subscribed, please consider doing so. It really helps my channel grow and reach more Taylor Swift fans and, you know, general people on YouTube that might want to discover cool music and reactions. Already at 200 subscribers, so thank you from the bottom of my heart. Without further ado, we'll jump into this.
Because when you watch a film or you read a book and there's a character that you identify with, you most of the time identify with them because they're targeting something in you that feels that you've been there. That's why we relate to characters. And so when I was reading, you know, Rebecca by Daphne du Maurier, I was thinking, wow, her husband just tolerates her. She's doing all these things and she's trying so hard and she's trying to impress him and he's just tolerating her the whole time. There was a part of me that was, you know, relating to that because at some point in my life I felt that way, and so I ended up writing this song, Tolerate It, that's all about sort of trying to love someone who's ambivalent.
All right, I just want to mention that I guess my patron stitched together some conversation ahead of time, so I have a little more context. That's where that clip is from. And apparently this song is inspired from a book called Rebecca, in which her husband tolerates her. So I'm expecting some visceral lyrics here. Looking forward to it. So I just wanted to comment about the tone of her voice here. It's melodic, soft, and just emotional. It sounds like this first verse is going to be about how she's sort of observing the person that she's with and basically soaking up every part of their essence, right? Like, she adores this person, it seems like. You know, those unequal relationships where you really feel like all of the intention, all of the thought is from one person in that relationship, and the other person sitting there just, you know, receiving those benefits or receiving that love, but maybe it's not reciprocated. I went back a little bit, so. Don't do you so much older. Wiser and I wait by the door like I'm just a kid. Use my best colors for your portrait. Okay, I have to stop there. It's too good. The chorus is coming in here. I'm gonna rewind it a little bit. You're so much older and wiser, and I wait by the door like I'm just a kid. And that falsetto. she brings that up in the chorus there is ooh, it's good. She's so talented in that regard. She can transform a chorus just with that, just her voice. And she has, there's like a little symbol in the back here, like that gives it this kind of like anticipatory build up to it. Like any good movie, you know? Ooh, I'm liking this. Let's go back. I just want to hear that transition from the verse one to the chorus.
Much older and wiser and I wait by the door like I'm just a kid. Use my best colors for your portrait. Lay the table with the fancy shit and watch you tolerate it if it's all.
Okay, so essentially I'm waiting all day for you to come home from work or wherever you've been, and I'm just so happy to see you. You know, like the build-up rush of emotion of like being, you know, back with your significant other. You know, I'm using literally the best supplies I have to create your portrait. You know, my paints and oils, and I lay the table with your favorite meal, and you walk in, and all you have for me is ugh. I'll tolerate you. That's heavy shit right there. That's basically the equivalent of getting slapped in the face by someone you love, and yeah, it's just like disregard for who you are. Sorry, I'm pausing a lot, but there's a lot to dig in here.
And watch you tolerate it if it's all in my head. Tell me now. Tell me I've got it wrong somehow. And all my love should be celebrated, but you tolerate it. I greet you with the battle heroes, welcome. I take your indiscretions all in good fun.
Okay, so, ooh, interesting. I take your indiscretions all in good fun. So basically, I like how she did that. So she's basically forgiving as she goes because this person means so much to her that she's willing to look the other way at his indiscretions, whether that's cheating, maybe just emotional cheating, or just you know, being secretive and not telling her everything she needs to know because she cares enough. She's willing to put up with that. And she's younger, it sounds like, in this track. So, not her, but she based this off the book. So, I think this is speaking to how, in your first relationships, you're willing to really look the other way. And you're learning if someone's a lot older than you, they can absolutely take advantage of you in all the wrong ways.
I sit and listen. I polish plates until they gleam and glisten. You're so much older and wiser, and I wait by the door like I'm just.
It's very ethereal, her voice.
Just a kid. Use my best colors for your portrait. Lay the table with the fancy shit and watch you tolerate it. If it's all in my head, tell me now.
She knows her love should be celebrated. We're conscious of this. Yet we cast it away in the hopes that, you know, one day it'll all change. You know, she's polishing, as she goes to make it gleam. You know, she's spending her whole day being considerate. The buildup of seeing someone, and then they just don't care. It's really sad. This is an emotional song. This is very, very vulnerable. If there's more backstory beyond Rebecca, let me know. The book, Rebecca. But thank you, Tall, my subscriber, for putting that clip there in the beginning. It's good to know that this is based off a fictional work, but obviously, like, this is such a common theme in people's relationships. Like, you know, one person just cares more usually. That's not always true, but it's a common theme in some relationships where it's unequal.
Well, he will outbuild another world where we are. With that man who threw blankets over my barbed wire. I'm leaving my temple, my little mascot.
Yeah, these lines are too good not to break down. While you were out building other worlds, where was I? So you're off at your day job, you know, conquering the world or whatever, you know, building. But where was I? Was I even thought about at all while you were out doing these things? Or were you out traveling under some consulting job and I was at home just thinking of you?
Was that man throw blankets over
my barbed wire. I'm hurt, I'm exposed, I'm vulnerable. I need that man to come in, not that it doesn't always have to be the man, but I need that person in my life to come over and comfort me, right? To make those wounds feel better. You're everything. Sorry, these are too good. These lines are amazing. I hope you forgive me for pausing, but now I'm begging for footnotes in the story of your life. You know, footnotes, right? This is absurd, right? I'm not even a main feature in your life. I want to be a footnote, something you look at and have to turn back to the appendix to figure out what it actually means. I mean nothing to you, apparently. You tolerate me. I'm going to go back because I don't want to disrupt the flow of the song, but these three lines were incredible.
You tolerate me. While he were out building other worlds, where was I? Was that man who threw blankets over my barbed wire? I'm aging my temple, my wheel in my sky. Now I'm begging for footnotes in the story of your life. Drawing hearts in the byline. Always taking up too much space or time. You assume I'm fine, but what would you do if I...
Oh God, the tone of her voice is so good. It's so good. Okay, so what would you do if I broke free and left us in ruins, or break free and leave us in ruins? So now she's contemplating leaving this person, and she's running through the thoughts in her head, telling her to do this, and what would the outcomes be?
Took the stagger in me and removed it. Gain the weight of you, then lose it.
Shed all those.
Believe me, I could do it.
Yes.
If it's all in my head, tell me now. Tell me I got it wrong somehow. I know my love should be celebrated, but you tolerate it.
I like that last song. You know, it's easy to interpret lyrics, I sit and watch you, as creepy, but it's definitely not. That's just more, hey, I have adoration for you, and you don't give me the time of day. And that last line in the previous chorus about, believe me, I could do it, is basically saying, I have the strength to break out of this relationship if I'm not getting the needs that I have fulfilled. This is a two-way tango, my friend, and if you're not willing to participate, I'm out. You can go off and build worlds, but I can do other things without you. I can build a world without you, too. Damn, that was heavy. That was heavy. I don't know where to rank these songs in my head anymore, and I don't think Taylor Swift songs need to be even ranked, honestly. They make me feel the way they feel in the moment, and I'm sure for many of you who've listened to these songs time after time, they may be morph and change as you go, and they mean things to you at different points in your life. I have artists like that that are not Taylor Swift that I've been listening to for many years, and songs that I, you know, once meant something to me mean a completely different thing. But in this case, it's a very vulnerable song, one of the best I've listened to by her, where she just lays it all on the line. Yeah, it makes me sad, but also it ends on a positive note because she at least has the strength to commit to possibly leaving this person. Anyways, thank you so much for sticking around. If you made it this far, please like and subscribe. Turn on the notifications. I do have a Patreon page where you can request songs and support me. And I really appreciate everyone that comments and lets me know what I could be doing better or just compliments me. I appreciate you being here. So I'll see you in the next one.